Hello friends, this is Supriya. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video we will focus on how do clouds form. Like this guy over here, you must have wondered what are clouds, why they move over the sky and how do they form. So friends, without any delay, let's discuss all of these. Starting with the introduction, let's study what are clouds made of. Friends, the moving clouds we see over the sky are not made of gases. Instead, they are made of tiny water droplets or tiny ice-like crystals that are suspended in the air. Now the question is, in which region these clouds are located? So the answer is, clouds are seen in the region of Earth homosphere, that includes troposphere, stratosphere and mesosphere layers. And between these layers, clouds appear at different levels, namely low, mid and high level clouds. Now we will discuss the four common types of clouds based on their shape. Cirrus clouds are thin, wispy and often curved. Cumulus clouds appear like big and fluffy cotton balls. Stratus clouds appear as flat sheets of clouds. Nimbus clouds appear grey and dense and they produce rain and snowfall. Now coming into the purpose of clouds, let's discuss why they are important. First, clouds function as protective shields. In a daytime, these protect us from the sun's heat and redistribute extra heat from the equator towards the pole. Clouds also produce rainfall that is necessary to replenish water to the earth, because without precipitation, there would be dry all over. The pattern of clouds helps in forecasting weather and climatic changes and also helps in modeling the impact of these changes in the future. Now it's time to study how clouds are formed. First, the solar heat reaches different water bodies and makes the water surface warm. Then the liquid water transits into a gaseous phase by forming water vapors, and this process is known as evaporation. You can relate this step to the vapors formed during the boiling of water. The water vapors suspended in the air have considerable freedom of movement, so they move freely upwards in the atmosphere. Eventually, this warm air parcel reaches a certain height where it meets the cold temperature, or the region where the temperature and atmospheric pressure gradually drops. This region is particularly called point of saturation for the clouds. Then the vapors enter the condensation nuclei and transform into liquid droplets or ice crystals. Later, the water molecules associate with the dust and smoke particles to form tiny masses. At last, the tiny masses transform into clouds that move over the sky. We will end up this video by taking a quick summary on the cloud formation process. So first, the liquid water evaporates into the air as water vapors. Then these water vapors reach a point where the surrounding air cools below its dew point and condense into water droplets. After that, the water droplets clump with the dust and smoke particles present in the atmosphere and form tiny cloud droplets. These cloud droplets associate to form clouds. When enough cloud droplets form within the cloud, it leads to rainfall and snowfall, and the process is called precipitation. So friends, that's all for today. To know this topic more in detail, you can visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So if you find this lesson useful, do like, comment, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for more videos.